By looking at the ECG, we can also find out what is the heart axis or the cardiac axis. Cardiac axis actually tells us in totality in which direction the wave of depolarization of the heart as a whole muscle is actually moving, because there is a concept of having a positive and a negative lead. But before that, we need to understand one very important factor, that the basic foundation of the ECG is P, Q, R, S and T complexes. And this analogy goes exactly like when a brick is the foundation or the element of the wall. So why we have a P? Because ECG is not the contraction or the relaxation. This is all about the electrical activity of the heart. So P is actually atrial depolarization, and QRS complex, it is the ventricular depolarization, and ventricular repolarization is depicted on the ECG in the terms of T. So we have P, Q, R, S, and T, which represents the atrial depolarization, ventricular depolarization, ventricular repolarization in this way. Atrial repolarization is buried somewhere underneath the QRS complex, because these two events, atrial depolarization and the atrial repolarization and the ventricular depolarization, are happening simultaneously. So whenever we look at the ECG, first of all, we need to understand what is the basis on which we talk about the ECG. This is the electrocardiography, electrical representation of the heart on the paper of like this ECG paper or the graph. So this is a P wave, QRS complex, and the T wave. So when we are to talk about cardiac axis, first we need to understand what we are talking about. Now there are two types of ECG leads. Negative leads, wherein the S wave is the deeper one, and R is a very small deflection upward, and there is a positive lead. In positive lead, we have a tall R wave and a very small S wave. Why we have actually negative lead and why we have positive lead? When the wave of depolarization moves away from a particular lead, we call it a negative lead. But when a wave of depolarization is moving towards a particular electrode or lead, we call it a positive lead, because it generates a tall R wave, while a negative lead generates a deep S wave and a very small R wave. So we need to understand two, three things up till now, that there is a P wave, there is a QRS complex, and there is a T wave. P is atrial depolarization, QRS is ventricular depolarization, and T is ventricular repolarization. In terms of cardiac axis, R and S wave, they are very important. Why we have a tall R wave? Because when wave of depolarization is moving towards a particular electrode. Why we have a deep S wave? Because when a wave of depolarization is going away from that electrode or any other of the electrode, which would give us a negative lead on the ECG. Just giving you one example. If we look at this ECG, here there is a tall R wave in lead V5 and V6. It means the wave of depolarization is actually going towards these leads. But when we see lead V1 or V2, there is a deep S wave and a very small R wave. So wave of depolarization is going away from these two leads. So V1 and V2 are negative leads. V5 and V6 are positive leads. When we talk about the cardiac axis, there are two leads which are very important, lead 1 and lead AVF. There are some books and there are some videos where you will find lead 1 and lead 2, lead 1 and lead 3. It can be, it is quite interchangeable, but for the starters, you should know lead 1 and lead AVF are important when you are to talk about heart axis or the cardiac axis. A normal cardiac axis is when the lead 1 and AVF both are positive. There is a tall R wave in lead 1, there is a tall R wave in lead AVF, and both have got small S wave. We call both 1 and AVF are positive leads, so this is a normal cardiac axis. But in the left axis deviation, lead 1 is positive and lead AVF is negative. So lead 1 has got a tall R wave and a very small S wave, and lead AVF has got a very small R wave and a deep S wave. So wave of depolarization is moving towards lead 1 and going away from the lead AVF. We call it left axis deviation, and there are some major causes. Like most of the time in emergencies and ICUs, when you find you come across a long standing hypertensive patient, you will have the their ECGs which has one lead 1 positive and AVF negative, and we call the patient is having left axis deviation. I can give you one example. When you look at this ECG, this patient presented in the emergency department, and patient has got a history of long-standing hypertension. Here you see lead 1 is positive and lead AVF is negative. Lead AVF has got a deep S wave and a very small R wave. But lead 1 has a large S wave and a very small or sort of non-existing S wave. So this is an example of the left axis deviation, and in this patient, the cause is long-standing hypertension. So in this patient, wave of depolarization is moving away from the lead AVF and is going towards lead 1. Some other major causes of the left axis deviation are left ventricular hypertrophy, left bundle branch block, Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome, and yes, anterior wall MI can also have most of the time left axis deviation. Another very important presentation in emergency departments and ICUs is pulmonary hypertension, asthmatic, COPDians, and smokers. These are the patients who are suffering from the chronic bronchitis or emphysema for a long time, and they have developed right axis deviation. In the right axis deviation, lead 1 is a negative lead and lead AVF is a positive lead. Lead 1 has got a deep S wave and a very small R wave. Lead AVF has a tall R wave and a very small S wave. When you have one negative and AVF positive, we call it left axis deviation. Wave of depolarization is going towards AVF and away from the lead 1. Some major causes are pulmonary hypertension, right ventricular hypertrophy, right axis deviation, and lateral wall MI and ventricular ectopics. These are the causes of right axis deviation. How you find out right axis deviation on the ECG? Lead 1 would be negative and lead AVF would be positive. So as it is said that one needs to be away from the extremes. Extreme behaviors and extreme personalities are always very rare. Same goes with the extreme right axis deviation. In extreme right axis deviation, lead 1 and lead AVF both are negative. Heart is jeopardized in a way that it is not generating so much electrical activity, and that electrical activity is not going towards neither of the lead 1 and AVF, so both are negative. We call it extreme right axis deviation or no man's land. Both lead 1 and lead AVF are negative, and the causes of the lead 1 and AVF being negative or the extreme right axis deviation are ventricular tachycardia and pacemaker, be it the temporary or the permanent pacemaker, because the ventricle is generating its own electrical activity under the effect of the pacemaker. So extreme right axis deviation is not a good thing. Like when you are doing, if a patient has got a heart which is not good enough to contract properly, so that is major causes of the extreme right axis deviation. This is you can say the simplistic way of knowing the cardiac axis, but this is I always say it a bit educated way of knowing, rather than going after the thumbs, thumb up, thumb down, right and left. That is not the way to remember it. And exactly same goes with the left together, right apart. These analogies are not good for a class of a people who are known as a doctor, because they are supposed to be educated. So this is the least educated way of knowing the cardiac axis. I would try to make the circle and give a little bit insight into the cardiac axis in another way, which is higher than this way of knowing the cardiac axis.